counting down. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. Keep on. 2, 1. Keep on.
No, it's when does Colin O'Day get the run with the shot? Run with the shot.
Don't worry, baby. Your try's coming.
Long sort of hiatus from the business to focus on her business and her family, Rihanna is making a return to the biggest stage possible, headlining the Super Bowl, clearly making peace with the NFL for TV's biggest night.
The NFL confirming Rihanna's halftime show, which will be sponsored by Apple Music and produced by Roc Nation. Roc Nation's founder Jay-Z posting, "Rihanna's a generational talent, a woman of humble beginnings who surpassed expectations at every turn, a person born on the small island of Barbados who became one of the most prominent artists ever." Announcement meant a major shift for the pop star, who previously turned down the role, speaking out against the NFL about the perceived blacklisting of quarterback Colin Kaepernick, whose protest against racial injustice sparked backlash. Telling Vogue, "I couldn't dare do that. For what? Who gains from that? Not my people. I just couldn't be a sellout. I couldn't be an enabler. My people. I just couldn't be a sellout. I couldn't be an enabler. There's things within that organization that I do not agree with at all, and I was not about to go and be of service to them in any way."
Perhaps the craziest fact of all about Kaepernick's protest, given the larger-than-life role it plays in sports today, is how, when it first happened, nobody noticed. August 2016 started out as just another NFL preseason, but this time, quarterback Colin Kaepernick began taking a seat during the anthem before the San Francisco 49er preseason games. It took until the third preseason game on August 26th for a single reporter to even comment on it, when a zoomed-out photo captured Kaepernick sitting on the bench. When asked about it in an interview with NFL reporters, he explained that sitting was to protest ongoing issues with police brutality and the oppression of people of color. "I'm not going to stand up to show pride in a flag for a country that oppresses black people and people of color. To me, this is bigger than football, and it would be selfish on my part to look the other way. There are bodies in the street and people getting paid leave and getting away with murder." Kaepernick was referencing a series of events that spurred the Black Lives Matter movement, specifically the police shootings of Alton Sterling and Philando Castile. On August 28th, he met with the media again, where he expressed support for the troops and reiterated his true intentions. "I'm going to continue to stand with the people that are being oppressed. To me, this is something that has to change. When there's significant change, and I feel that flag represents what it's supposed to represent, and this country is representing people the way it's supposed to, I'll stand." After meeting with former Green Beret and NFL player Nate Boyer, Kaepernick decided to adjust his protests in order to not take away from the military, but keep the focus on what the issues really are. So on September 1st, Kaepernick took a knee during the anthem, where he was joined by his teammate Eric Reid. After the game, he announced a $1 million donation to charities focusing on racial issues. In the following weeks and months, other athletes began to follow suit. Whether it was an NFL peer or soccer player, a knee or a fist, the message spread nationwide. The protests sparked controversy that reached as far as the White House.
Wouldn't you love to see one of these NFL owners, when somebody disrespects our flag, to say, get that son of a bitch off the field right now. Out. He's fired. He's fired.
Trump doubled down on his statement, calling for a rule requiring players to stand. NFL owners briefly passed, and then suspended, a rule in May 2018 that would have fined the teams of players who protested during the anthem. Negotiations over an official anthem policy remain ongoing between the league and the players' union. Police brutality remains an ongoing issue in American society. Kaepernick is unemployed by the league, but the new face of a Nike campaign.
Asking for crazy enough.
...2016 was a very notable, remarkable year for the Black Panther Party, 50-year anniversary, Colin Kaepernick sitting out on August
26th.
Good.
A little unrational for 88.
See, 88, that's when Rihanna was born. So that's how we're going to get back to the circle of all this NFL, Black Panther, rockets in space, darts program, fentanyl outbreak. It all comes together. And only here at Damn Goods will you see all this, how it all works, all these connections. Let's take a look together. Hey, yo. Romeo Must Die. We had the song Try Again. And you notice the fist. And it's about the fist, power, communism, socialism. You have Colin Kaepernick, Black Panther Party. Newton played in the game, 2016. I don't know if you all noticed that he turned into a Black Panther. If we look at some of the symbolism in Romeo Must Die, we even have the date 8/26, like the day Colin Kaepernick sat out. And in the movie, there was a man named Colin.
All I know is, when does Colin O'Day get the run with the show?
He talks about running with the show, but he ends up falling from a tower. So we gotta pray for that. And it was like a predictive programming for 9/11, all the people that sadly fell out of the tower. And it's also magic, because there's a tower card in the tarot deck where they fall from towers. Let's take a look at that. Just really quick. This is from the video I did, Airplanes, Alia 911. And you have XVI in Roman numerals. The X over here stands for 10, V, 5. And I is one, so that's the 16th card. And you can see they have a man and a woman falling from a tower. And you see that the tower's on fire, struck by lightning. It's like a catastrophe, and the crown falls off of the tower. So somebody from a lofty place falling down. So we have to see what happens with Colin Kaepernick. But now that Rihanna has gotten, I guess, his blessing, everything is set and moving in order. The new order. Just to mention, this is also called a trump card in the tarot deck. The tower card. It's a trump card. Romeo Must Die was released in March 22nd, 2000, the year Y2K. And you see that there's a hidden code for the date of 8/26/01 revealed in the movie. And it turns out 8/26 is when we were told of Aaliyah's tragic crash in the Bahamas, which isn't very hard, far from Barbados. And 8/26 is also the day Keke Palmer was born. And it's also related to the day that the astronaut who went to outer space, he died on 8/25. Also, August 26th is the day of the women's suffrage movement having a successful win for women to vote. So this date is a very important date. Also, 8/25 is the date for Kyle Rittenhouse, I think his name was, and the whole thing during 2020 and the Black Lives Matter and the Antifa protests over in Kenosha. So we have a lot going on with the show on 8/26, 8/25. And many may know that Kaepernick pledged a Greek fraternity in college called Kappa Alpha Psi. And they're well known for their stepping with a cane. It's a way that they show their fraternal, I don't know, momentum. And you see the colors are red and white. Interesting. Kappas are known for their new twirling and stepping with the canes, which is very interesting and such a great entertaining display of showmanship and technique. And it's just pretty cool to be on a college campus and see, you know, all the fraternities doing their stepping. But this is what makes Kappas very, very distinguishable from others, with their red and white and their canes. If you look familiar in the Try Again video, that was part of the soundtrack for Romeo Must Die. They have the cane and they're talking about stepping. Without a deal, beat the step twos. Wow, she's working it. Work it. She brings us to NASA and the rockets and going to the moon and the moon shots and Rihanna. And here we go.
A spacecraft intentionally crashed into an asteroid on September 26th.
Oh, wow.
As part of a roughly $325 million mission. Intentionally crashed into an asteroid on September 26th.
It's just an interesting connection that Apple Music posted that Rihanna was going to take the stage for the Super Bowl halftime show on February 12th, 23, a couple days before her birthday. And it was posted on September 25th. Happened to be at 7:15 p.m., exactly 24 hours before the dart hit the asteroid Dimorphos. Wow, I didn't know it was exactly 7:15 p.m. one day before NASA's rocket hit the asteroids. This kind of looks like the asteroids. They hit this little asteroid called Dimorphos. This is, one is called Dimorphos and the other one's called Diddy. It sounds like P. Diddy. So interesting. Oh my gosh. We're just discovering things as we're reporting on these connections. See, they make sure to say the announcement for Rihanna was made on September 25th. So these dates are so important. It's exactly a month after the memorial of Aaliyah's passing. The
collision is part of NASA's double asteroid redirection test, also known as DART. So why did NASA crash a multi-million-dollar spacecraft into an asteroid? And what will scientists learn from it? In fact, NASA launched DART.
3, 2, 1. And liftoff of the Falcon 9 and DART.
Targeted the binary asteroid system Didymos, which is composed of two asteroids. Didymos, the larger asteroid, and its smaller moonlet, Dimorphos. Magnetic impactor technology, which involves using spacecraft. According to NASA, DART collided into the asteroid at roughly 14,000. According to Earth Object, to change its orbit, which involves using spacecraft designed to deflect a near-Earth object to change its orbit.
And we can see that's clearly Africa. Now we'll see Africa again. Shooting stars are usually asteroids. We can see here, that was Africa again. Let's look at that again. This is Diamonds in the Sky, sung by Rihanna at Saturday Night Live. And isn't it so curious that she's got a picture of Africa behind her? And she's gonna actually point to the same area of Africa that's shown in the NASA video. I just realized this the other day. And she actually points to it. And it's what we would call in the Black Panther movie, Wakanda. Remember, meteor looks like, a meteor looks like a diamond in the sky. It looks like a star or a shooting star. Your shooting star, I see a picture of ecstasy. And she talks about moonshine and Molly. These are drugs. We'll be talking about later a little bit. So what's up with Africa being pinpointed with asteroids and meteors? We're gonna see it again. And we notice, you notice that Rihanna often is depicted as a tribalistic African type in many of her videos, which is so great, showing and displaying African and Caribbean and even like Hawaiian type tribal motifs. Even her tattoos look tribal. And so we are all in on that, the love of the people. But I wonder if there's a greater connection here. Well, let's just take a look. I was looking at the new Gru Minions movie, The Rise of Gru, from 2022. And they show a picture of Africa. And in the background, you can see right in the same area of Wakanda, East Africa area, where Kenya and Tanzania and parts of Sudan are. They have that lion there as another point of reference. And here at the end of the SNL performance, again, Africa is pinpointed, this time a little north of Wakanda area, and Wakanda is fictional, it's MCU, but East Africa. But I bring up Wakanda on purpose because of Black Panther and all the connections to it. But if you notice the end of this song, let's see if you can hear something that sounds familiar. Yeah, the way her song ended, it's like the beginning of Kanye West's song about the blood diamonds in Africa. And diamonds, like the diamonds in the sky, like the meteors that hit. But we have to know if the meteors actually mean meteors or something that's shot into people, a shot onto the land. The blood diamonds we're talking about now. Our blood, our DNA. Yeah.
Here, called DART, Double Asteroid Redirection Test. Again, test. And they say that this has to do with outer space. But as we saw earlier, they were directing it towards Africa. Now, why are they directing it towards Africa? That's a really good question, isn't it? So basically,
also, when you look at the logo for DART, you see it's like the arrow, the same arrow like our cursor on our computers, but it also looks like the same spacecraft of the asteroid game.
Atari days, and DART is targeting this poor little rock that's just out there having fun in outer space. It's actually something called Didymos. So when you think Didymos, think of P. Didymos, okay? Called Dimorphos. Think of di meaning two, Morpheus, okay? Morpheus. He is named after the god of sleep.
Yeah, the god of sleep. And think about the pills, the red and blue pill, but they could also be talking about Zantac, which is a sleeping pill. Which pill are you going to take to go to sleep? They want to keep our butts asleep.
So, with their dart. Now, think about a dart. We can think about this dart, like a dart hitting a bullseye. But if you add an H, we get Darth. Like Darth Vader or Darth Maul. But I kind of like this Darth better. And I'll tell you more about why later.
Yeah.
This is Spaceballs from the 80s. Once Upon a Time Warp. Remember, Donald Trump had warp speed for the vaccines. And this one.
Make way for Dark Helmet.
All rise in the presence of Dark Helmet.
Notice his tie. His tie looks like male reproductive organ. Remember, this is called Space Balls. And we decoded that Epididymis or Didymus is representing the balls in Space Balls. And what they plan to do and direct with their darts. The darts are directed towards the space balls.
I can't breathe in this thing.
I know, wearing a mask. Oh my gosh.
Approaching planet fluidity, sir. Good. Sir, I don't see planet fluidity. Sanders! Sir! Radar screen. Shall I punch it up for you?
Nah, never mind. I'll do it myself.
Know that? Of course I do. Care for some? Yes! I always have coffee when I watch radar. You know that? Of course I do, sir. Everybody knows that! Of course! Now that I have my coffee,
Yeah, so she was Tip Gratuity Jones in the movie Home. So cute. And she did a fantastic job, I thought. But she had a friend who was of the alien race in the movie. And it turns out that the genetic sac, it's a rock, was actually the target in this movie as well.
Tip is a young girl who is very independent, very sassy, a lot of attitude, but she's fun and she's still a little girl. And you know, at times her strength is very deceiving because you almost forget that she's a little girl all alone, because the entire journey is for her to find her mom. Home is a very emotional film. My friends call me Tip.
I am Poe.
What is your name?